In this Fixture Friday, we're gonna take a look at our oldest, most used, and quite frankly, our most beat up fixture to see how it's held up over the years. Okay, the part we're making today might be familiar to a lot of our existing customers. These are known as toe clamps, and they're used to hold our vacuum chucks and pallet systems to the machine table. Now, these toe clamps are made out of 1018 steel and are roughly 1.5 by 3/4 inch thick. We use 4 tools to make this part: a 531 drill, a 1/2 inch rougher, 1/2 inch finisher, and a chamfer mill. Now, since we make about 1,200 of these parts every production run, we have to palletize and we have to machine aggressively yet reliably. For example, we rough these parts at 6,000 RPM and 400 inches a minute, full depth of cut, and 0.005 radial step over. I went back and looked through the records, and we've made 10,000 parts with these pallets over the years. That works out to each part location seeing over 1,200 clamping cycles in each pocket. So let's take a closer look. Well, they're obviously well used, but still as accurate as day one. Okay, let's talk about the design. This is a 10-inch by 12-inch pallet. First thing to notice is that this pallet runs both the first and second operations. 8 parts here for op 1, which then move down here for op 2. Notice the pallet is also symmetrical with a mirror image down the center line. Now, the reason for this is it's just simply easier to draw. I created my first 2 part locations, patterned them up, and then mirrored them over. Another thing we could have done is to use a larger 16-inch long pallet to get 2 more rows, but one thing to consider is the human factor. Now, this pallet as it is weighs 23 pounds, and a larger pallet would weigh about 35 pounds. Now, since our efficiency is already 8 times more productive than 2 parts in a vise, there's really no good reason to put a burden of more weight on the operator. Now, one thing that happens over time is the back side of the clamp either wears or dents the wall of the pocket. If it goes too deep, it shifts the position of the clamp, and we run the risk of not clamping on the part at all. Knowing this would happen, I designed this back wall to be shifted 0.020 closer to the part to compensate for future wear. Okay, the stats. This pallet has a cycle time of 14 minutes, 10 seconds, which works out to a finished part every 1 minute, 46 seconds. Only 4 total tool changes for the entire pallet versus 32 changes if we were running 2 in a vise, both operations. Oh, and since we're running both ops on 1 pallet, we only did 1 setup. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to our channel where we aim to share a bunch of information to make this industry more efficient. So until next time, go innovate your production.